Hey friends, how you doing today? We are going to do a breaking down the score, and we're going to do One Short Day from Wicked the Musical. I haven't done this one yet, and I'm pretty surprised. I think it's too long to play through the entire thing, so instead we're just going to break it down as we go. So, first page, we have the One Short Day in the Emerald City. And then you have the pretty chord. So these chords are setting us up for the whole song. So it's kind of fragmented, a little bit of an introduction. Short day in the Emerald City. Now, I think, and this is all my theory and guess, but things aren't going to go so right with the Wicked Witch coming in later. So this, I feel like, is a chord that is foreshadowing right here. This chord, I think I can circle it. There we go. It's foreshadowing with this D natural against a C sharp sus chord. So we've had this theme throughout this whole show. Like when you listen to Defying Gravity, you have that falling unlimited theme. Well, they kind of play with it here a little bit with these descending. It's not the same notes. If it were, that's what it would be. But it's a little different. Still similar feel as the other times it's played when it's the unlimited theme. But then when we come to this section, it inverts itself and it goes up instead of down, descending. So you have, instead of, so he plays a lot on those 16th notes as a, I look at it as like a launching off point for the song. It's like, because that's when it starts to speed up and get at the right tempo. So you get the one short day, always wanted to see the Emerald City. One short day in the Emerald City. And it's this whole opening. And it's there right there, that 16th note pattern. So this is how it functions. One short day in the Emerald City. I've always wanted to see the Emerald City. 16th notes, one short day in the Emerald City. And it's got that weird chord launching off. Next page. One short day in the Emerald City. One short day full of so much to do. So now, here's the thing with this song. You notice that Stephen Schwartz in this whole musical has a lot of ascending octave bass lines that are very rhythmically charged. Think of, I'm going to keep going back to Defying Gravity. One, one, two, three, four. He's got the same thing here, except it's not the same rhythm. If we look even at the beginning of this phrase, where he has these bass notes that are doing the same exact thing. Bum, 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 bum. So it's one, two, three, three, four. Except the rhythm is changed. Instead of the Defying Gravity rhythm, you have that one. So he's sticking to a thematic groove for this whole thing, through this whole show. And now he's changed it a little bit, but he still is keeping some of what I call the DNA of the musical together. Okay, so it continues. Every way that you look in the city. And there's that D natural that we hinted at the beginning of the song. There's something exquisite You'll want to visit before the day's through. And then we go into the B section. Totally different key change. It's like a totally different tone. But this is what Wicked's about. It keeps changing keys constantly, tonalities. We're never in the same freaking key most of the time. So you have buildings tall as quoxwood trees, dress salons and libraries, palaces, museums 100 strong. Now we have that pattern again, those 16th notes, running 16th notes on the fourth beat of a lot of this. It's not the same exact notes, but it's the same figure and the same rhythmic pattern going on. Strong. There are wonders like I've never seen. It's all grand and it's all green. Get it? Green like the color of her skin. I think we found a place where we belong. I want to be in this hoi polloi. And so now, different colors, a lot of fun keys and stuff going on that really don't stick together. My favorite thing is this bar 28, 29 right here. We have a G7 sus going to a G7 to a G minor 7. Something about going from the parallel major, getting really technical here, the parallel major to the parallel minor, something about... has something beautiful about that. My favorite is also going from a major 7 to a minor 7. It just, I don't know, something about it makes me get all nice and warm and fuzzy inside. So, polloi, I'll be back for good someday to make my life and make a way. So listen, so again, this ascending bass line stuff happens right here at bar 32. So I'll be back for good someday. So it's building upwards. You know, we're getting to a climax in the song. I'll be back for good someday to make my life and make my way. But for today, we'll wander and enjoy harmonies. Back to the old key. One short day. So we just went from... it's quite interesting. Key change. One short day in the Emerald City. So we know this material. Full lifetime of fun. Every way that you look in a city. Now that we're in. Live here before we are done. New key? Because we have dialogue going on. Okay. So now we get back into like this Broadway vibe going on. Who's the mage? Whose major itinerary is making all us merrier? So now this sounds like... it's that circus-y music, which is fitting for what's going on stage. So you have who's the mage, whose major itinerary is making all us merrier. All the chromatic stuff going on in that melody. Who's the sage who sagely sailed in to save our posteriors? By the way, I never know what the hell they're saying. I finally now know what the lyrics are. Who's enthused for hot air ballooning has all of Oz honeymooning? Who isn't he wonderful? Like isn't, but whiz, you know, play on words. But again, until you like look at the lyrics, you don't really know what these lyrics are. I always feel like I don't know what the hell they're singing in this section when I listen to it on the cast recording. Then you have our wonderful wizard. And now he superimposes the who's the mage Who's Major with the One Short Day? He takes the main theme, One Short Day, in the Emerald City. And now we call it augmentation. We augment the rhythm, which means we just take shorter rhythms like One Short Day, and now we're going to make it really long. One short day in the Emerald City. So we augment the rhythm there, and we superimpose the B section with the circus music. Just pick a line, people. Emerald City, making all us merrier. Who's the sage? Who's sagely sailed in to save our posteriors? Then everybody together singing, again, an augmented rhythm version of the main theme. What a way to be seeing the city where so many roam to. Then echoes her. We'll call it home too. Then just like now we can say key change or a hint at a different key. Not really though, because we go back. We're just two friends, two good friends, two best friends. Again, now you notice we go from the G to a minor chord, major chord to a minor chord, to best friends. This is hinting at the song that Elphaba and Glinda sing for good at the end of the show. It's kind of there. It's a little germ of it, right at this measure here. Not a lot, just a germ. It's tiny. So you have two best friends. Then we go right back in, sharing one wonderful one short. The wizard will see you now. And then we go back to the opening. One short. So that is pretty much One Short Day from Wicked. Now, if any of you are writers out there, you can see how from cover to cover of this song, it's all thematic. Like, it's not like a new song that doesn't sound like it's from the show. It's pulling from different tonalities in different parts of the musical and injecting it here. So there's a lot, when you're writing a musical, there's a lot of like, what when I say like musical DNA, you're talking about the... So if I were to write a new song for Wicked, I would try to incorporate that. Like, you could make stuff up. I could take that material and write a new song with it, even though it's not my show. It could be like something sad going. I mean, you could do all kinds of wonderful shit with when you know the DNA of your musical. Musical DNA, I'm talking about. The themes, the identity of certain songs. You could inject that into different parts of different songs to make it all feel like it's coming from the same milieu. I love Wicked. I think it's brilliant. I think it's one of the best shows out there. It's well crafted. The story's great. It's original. You can't beat it. But anyway, I hope y'all have a great day, and I will talk to you soon, friends. Bye.